So you just ran. Hopefully you're wherever you are where you just ran. And we're gonna stretch it out. Today I'm gonna show you what I do after I run to stretch. And normally I do it where I ran, which today will happen to be at a park. A little hard to video myself if it's this cold at a park. So I'm back home after my run. And typically this is what I do. I start and I just inhale my arms up. And I grab one elbow, drop that hand behind my back, really press my head into that hand, into that elbow. I'm just trying to stretch out the tricep here. And continue to breathe. Just a couple of breaths. Maybe just moving a little side to side, really pressing your head back though. That's going to help you stretch out the muscle a bit more. Let that go. Bring your other arm up, bend the arm behind your back, push your head into the arm. You can even take that hand that's on your back and you can give yourself a little massage between your shoulder blades. And turn around, just go ahead. Our arms actually work pretty hard when we're running, so they can get more tired than you think they will. Let that go. The next thing I like to do, running is a really forward motion, but we need to stretch out the side body too. So I like to take one hand to a thigh, take the other arm up, really pressing into that thigh, bringing the arm up and over, and instead of collapsing down like this, you're really trying to stretch up. Get a really nice side stretch all the way down your body. And then to further that side stretch, I bring that hand up and then I just go down, around, and up about three times. It's also gonna stretch your hamstrings a little bit. It's a nice full body stretch. And we often don't do it in this lateral direction. And then bring the arms down, take your right hand to your thigh. Inhale, bring your left hand up, over, pressing into this right hand, really thigh into hand, hand into thigh. And we're trying once again to lengthen all the way from our hand, all the way down, push into that foot, and bring your right hand up. And once again, just drop it down, around, and up. Couple more times. It should feel really good. All the way back up. Maybe a little back stretch. Gentle. And come down. I've got my handy treadmill here. A wall works, a bench works, a tree works. And I'm going to come into pyramid pose. So I'm taking that right leg back while keeping the front leg straight. You want the back leg angled out a little bit, keeping both of those legs really active, trying to bring them towards each other, trying to bring your hips into neutral. You can even take a hand back to that hip, push it back. Take a couple of breaths here. And then just rotate that back foot so it's facing forward. Take your front foot, bend it a little bit, and then just bend into your back foot, straighten, bend, straighten, bend, straighten. Come to stillness. A nice stretch for your calf muscles. Keeping that front leg where it is, bend the back leg a little bit. It's going to get a little bit into your Achilles. It's just a slightly different angle to stretch out your calf muscles. A couple of deep breaths. Step the back foot to meet the front. Take the front foot back. Angle it out about 30 degrees. Come on down to a flat back position, pushing against whatever you have available, or taking your hands down to your shin, whatever works. A wall is nice. Thinking about trying to bring those legs together, really, really active. And take that back foot, face forward, bend the front foot. Once again, bend, straighten with your back leg, bend, straighten, bend, straighten. Come to stillness. You should feel this in your calf. A couple of breaths. Bend the back leg. Getting more into the Achilles. Kind of keep that back heel on the floor. And the back foot to meet the front. Notice how your legs are feeling. And I end with one last stretch. Take your hands to your hips. Bring your feet out as wide as you can. And take your feet, angle them in. We spend a lot of time working on external rotation in our hips. We don't spend as much time working on internal rotation. We need that for some balance. On the inhale, straighten your spine. On your exhale, slowly come down, pointing your head straight down at the floor. Legs are active. Knees aren't left out. You can bring your hands down to your thighs and help that internal rotation a little bit more. Take a few deep breaths. Really let your head relax towards the floor. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Take your hands to your hips. Very slowly come up to a flat back position. Pause. And slowly bring your abs in as you come all the way back up. And that's it. That's how I stretch out after a run. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you find these stretches really useful. And let me know in the comments if there's anything you'd like to see and what you liked about these stretches. Thanks so much for joining me to stretch it out today.